This is the circuit we are building today. At each step I will explain what the components do. There is a link in the description to a written version of this video. The op-amp needs power in order to function. The voltages we feed it are also the limits to what it can output. If we, for example, intend to drive a MOSFET with the output signal, we could give it 12 volts. But since this is only a demonstration, I'll give it 5 volts. The op-amp can change its output very rapidly. But we want a triangle wave, whose signals rise and fall slowly. So we need to slow it down somehow. The output of the op-amp first goes through a resistor to the negative input, to limit the current in a predictable way. Then we have it charge a capacitor, which takes time to charge and discharge. In order to oscillate, the inputs have to be able to overtake each other in terms of voltage. But the positive input will now be either the absolute maximum voltage of the op-amp or the absolute minimum. No room left on either end. So we add an equal value resistor divider to the same input. This divider will normally output a voltage right in the middle of the maximum and minimum voltage. In this case 2.5 volts. But it is also connected to the output through another resistor. This now causes the output voltage to be pulled a bit towards the middle voltage, leaving room on either end. What will happen in this part of the circuit? 1. Both inputs and output are low. Noise will eventually cause the positive input to be bigger than the negative, and the output goes high. 2. The output is high, and thanks to the three resistors, the positive input is less than 100% of the output. The capacitor is charging and voltage on the negative input is rising. 3. The negative input will eventually rise above the positive input, causing the output to go low. 4. The output is low. The three resistors make the positive input a bit above ground. The capacitor is discharging and voltage on the negative input is falling. 5. The negative input drops below the positive input. The output now switches to high again. 6. Continue the loop at point 2. There are a few things to observe here. First, the output signal, which is a square wave signal. Second, the positive input, which is also a square wave signal. If I overlap those two signals, I would expect to see the input signal is slightly dampened compared to the output. But it seems the difference is too small for that. But it is needed, that I am sure of. Third, the negative input signal, which is a triangle wave signal. Now, if I move the positive input signal over the negative one, we can see the triangle wave signal change direction as soon as it touches the square wave signal. Exactly what we wanted. Now that we have a triangle wave signal, we can use it to create a square wave signal. Therefore, we connect the negative input of the first op-amp to the positive input of the second op-amp. Now we add a potentiometer. One end to 5 volts and the other to ground. This makes it a variable resistor divider. The middle connection is the wiper of the potentiometer and now provides a selectable voltage between 5 volts and ground. We connect this voltage source to the negative input of the second op-amp. There are a few things to observe here. First, the output signal, which is the square wave signal. If I turn the potentiometer, you can see the duty cycle change. It can even go full on and full off. Second, the positive input, which is the triangle wave we saw earlier. Third, the negative input, which is the potentiometer. You can see it move up and down, but it has no waveform. Now, if I move all these signals to the same place, you can see that the output goes high as soon as the triangle wave signal goes over the potentiometer value. The lower the potentiometer value, the longer the output stays on. Thank you for watching. There is a link in the description to the written version of this video.